Hello everybody, today yes I want to talk about a book. The name of the book is Braveheart.
The Braveheart is a book written by Randall Wallace 1272 to 1305, and the battle between Scotland and England between 1239 to 37. The story began when William was a young boy. William's father and older brother fight against the English army, and they were killed. William grew up and becomes a rebel too. His story is one of love for a beautiful Scottish girl and hope for his country. It is a story of rebel attacks and terrible battle of a French princess and of the English king who wants to hold on to Scotland. The American writer Randall Wallace first heard about William Wallace when he visited Edinburgh Castle in Scotland. He learned more about William and decided to tell his story. Chapter 1. The Boy. In the beginning, Scotland had no king. The old king died without a son or daughter. The English king, First Edward, wanted to choose a new king for Scotland. The Scottish nobles wanted to choose their ruler. So there was war. One day, the First Edward Longshanks called a truce. The bravest Scottish nobles came. They came to the meeting place, a large farm building, and leaving their weapons behind. King Edward showed he was not honest, and he killed the Scottish nobles by hanging them up. William's father and his brother participated in the wars against the English army and died. When William stood at the graves, a little girl of 5 with long red hair came towards him and handed William a flower. Then he lived with his uncle in another place. Chapter 2. The Rebel. Robert the Bruce wanted to be king of Scotland, and 24 Scottish nobles were on his side. Another Scottish family, like the Balliols, also wanted to rule. They had many friends too, and there was war between the two families. The Balliols and the Bruce were all brave, but people could not trust them. They looked after themselves first and Scotland second. Sometimes they fought with the English and sometimes against them. When William becomes young, he decided to return to his land and live as a farmer. The next day, William started work on the farmhouse. At first, he refused to become a rebel, and he did not join the rebel. But after Heserig kills his secret wife, he decides to take revenge. He took his father's great sword from its hiding place, and the rebels followed. All through the valley, people took up their weapons and ran behind him towards Lanark, where Heserig and his men were waiting. The battle was short. No one could stop Wallace. English soldiers lie dead everywhere. Wallace found Heserig and pulled him out by his hair to the square. He took his sword and cut Heselrig's throat in one movement. He knew he won't fight as a rebel from this day until he died. Day after day, the number of people joining William increased. They win over the English soldiers in Stirling after a terrible battle. The water below the bridge was red with blood. Chapter 3. First Lord of Scotland. After the Battle of Stirling, William Wallace was famous all over Scotland. He rode into Edinburgh and up to the castle, friends at his side. He became the first Lord of Scotland. They gave him a gold ring of office, and the nobles went down on their knees. William decided to fight into England and beat the English on their own land. William began from York. William attacked York and took it. He sent the head of the governor of York to Long Shanks. William attacked York because every English attack on Scotland starts from there. Longshanks decided to send Princess Isabella to make a truce with the Scots. When she got there, she said, "I'm Princess of Wales, wife of the king's son. I come from the king and I speak for him." William looked at her and thought of his lost love. In London, Isabella reported on her meeting with Wallace. She listened to the king talking about his plan. So leaders were already on their way from Wales and French. And with terrible new weapon, they could cut through metal like a knife through butter. She realized that the king did not want a truce. Her words to William Wallace were lies. The king used her to win time. And now his soldiers were getting ready to attack the Scots army from the sides and from behind. The Battle of Falkirk was more terrible than Stirling. Of all Scottish nobles, only Morney was there with 100 riders. Robert the Bruce did not come. The famous Scottish spears lined up. The English horses began the attack from the right. The English foot soldiers shot their terrible new weapon at the spearmen from the left. Wallace ordered to Morney to attack the foot soldiers before they could shoot again. But Morney did not attack. Longshanks watched Morney riding away from the battle with his men. The English nobles turned to their king in surprise. William felt helpless. With Morney gone, no one was guarding the spearmen. The English foot soldier shot again the terrible weapon, cutting the Scottish spearmen to pieces. The rest of Scottish army did not wait for orders. They ran screaming towards the England. The battle was long and hard, so leaders on the both sides fought bravely, but there were two army English. Towards the end of this battle, the English horsemen attacked again. Wallace saw they coming. It was Robert the Bruce fighting for the English. Wallace looked at his face. In the second, he realized that there was no hope for Scotland. He felt weak. The Bruce waved his sword at Wallace. "Fight me, fight me," he shouted. But Wallace could not fight. Now, he took the gold ring of office of his finger and threw it at Robert the Bruce's foot. Stephen rode up quickly. He pulled William up behind him onto his horse and the two rode away from the battle. Chapter 4. Braveheart. A few months later, William rode into Lord Morney's bedroom and cut through his neck with one quick movement. The Scottish nobles now wanted a meeting with Wallace. They said that they wanted to serve him and not Longshanks. "Why do you trust them?" asked Hamish, shaking his head. "You know they will give you to Longshanks." "You are probably right, but we cannot win without them, Hamish. Standing together is the only hope for our people." "I don't want to die. I want to live," shouted Hamish. William, Stephen, and Hamish rode to the meeting place. William came into the house. In second, there were English soldiers everywhere. They tied William up like an animal, took him to London over the back of a horse, and threw him in prison. William Wallace died slowly in front of a great crowd on 23 August 1305. They did terrible things to his body so that he won't ask for forgiveness, but he would not. In the last second of his life, he saw Hamish and Stephen in the crowd and behind them Morin. For a moment he felt strong and he cried out, "We will be free."
Okay, I hope that the film has owned your admiration. Bye bye.